There are many morons in the world. One place that will never fall short of supply is the internet. No matter where you look, there's always some idiot cramming his aggressive opinion down other people's throats. I'm glad I'm not one of those people. Welcome to Counter-Strike Source, the game with the largest population of internet tough guys known to man. They talk big online and seemingly eat bullets for breakfast and shit concrete for tea. You know, those guys that when provoked, respond with real-life violent propositions like,
if you said that in real life, I'd
insert harmful suggestion. Or
say that to my face in person and I'd
insert harmful suggestion. Anyway, if these guys have taught me anything, it's that real men play
games.
Counter-Strike Source is similar to the American school system in the respect that you buy a gun and you shoot somebody. The game consists of counter-terrorists fighting terrorists to defuse or protect a bomb, prevent or enact the rescue of helpless hostages, or simply fight out in a bloodbath. Upon winning rounds, you are handed large sums of money with which you purchase guns and proceed to shooting your classmate. Matches start with a moment's halt where you and your companions magically congeal weapons from thin air. Each gun is subtly different from the next. One will have your enemies biting the dust in a few well-placed shots, and others will see success from simply spraying a general area and magically hitting someone's cranium. The major boomsticks include a stereotypical Kalashnikov for the hairy renegades, and an M4 for the fuzz. Occasionally you get someone who saves his pocket money and buys this. The AWP is a heavy weapon that will marginalise you in one shot, or sometimes two if you're a lucky bastard. All the other guns are pretty subpar, but they all have small qualities any perpetrator or homicide can appreciate. A round typically boils down to three phases. The first phase, where the two teams clash in large numbers, thinning the ranks of undesirables and reducing the amount of players alive usually by more than half. Phase 2, where the teams make a play for the map objective, resulting in a further cull. And phase 3, where the few lucky survivors of phase 1 and 2 appear against each other in what seems like sending two paranoid schizophrenics into a dark maze, telling both that the other guy is out to get them. Counter-Strike Source isn't exactly a game built on teamwork. From the second a round starts, Bob, Phil, John and Steve go left, or Jack, Cuthbert, Frank and Abdul go right, leaving you wondering which handful of mongoloids you're least likely to die with. There's a real lack of friendliness in some places. Make a small mistake and you'll be verbally assaulted by a guy named Cuntface5 telling you you're a 40-year-old bald man living in your mother's basement with several cats. Also, joining a server to have Barbie World shoved down my throat by the server sound package is always pleasant, and in the unlikely event that some sort of theme music doesn't play, there's always some lovely gentleman who'll decide everyone wants to hear his fantastic music and just massage your ears with his elegant symphonies. So it's safe to say that like all good first-person shooters, the Source community is filled with people that you want to manslaughter. Here's a bunch of colourful character types from Source that I'm sure you'll be pleased to meet. This player kills at least two-thirds of your team and is detested by all like a bad case of hemorrhoids. Side effects include server depopulation and a spike in nerd rage of player base. The guy that sits in the corner, most likely observing pornography outside the game for the whole round, hoping someone will walk past him so he can score an easy kill. Side effects include extended round times and a surge in nerd rage. The guy with the gun that one hits anything.
Unless you're a lucky bastard.
Side effects include increase in homophobic dialogue. This player sneakily puts bullets in the backs of his enemies and never makes a sound, like he's trained at more ninja training camps than the female population of Iran. Side effects include paranoia, tension and extended round times. The player that accuses anyone that kills them of cheating.
Oh my god, what the fuck was that? I know you're fucking hacking, you fucking definitely deserve a ban, you faggot.
Side effects include argumentative dialogue and the desire to kick an 11-year-old child in the face, preferably on his birthday. Some things in Counter-Strike don't really make sense. For instance, as a terrorist, when you shoot an escaping hostage, it subtracts large sums of money from you as if you've done something horribly wrong, when realistically, what honest-to-God terrorist wouldn't do this? And the terrorists aren't exactly winning medals of creativity with their choice of attack, either.
Hey Mohammed, let's blow up these empty boxes, that'll show those Allah infidels.
In the end, Source isn't a game so interesting you brag to your girlfriend about how you own some Gandhi dust, only to get told,
I don't care!
It offers nothing amazing, nor does it challenge the boundaries of gaming. It's simple, but therein lies its greatest asset. I think the game designers of today could learn a lesson or two from this respected senior of gaming, because sometimes it's good to stick to the basics. Buy some guns, grow some pigs, and send some Mexican guys to St. Peter. Just don't overdo it, or like everything else, it'll get so repetitive and monotonous your eyes will close and you'll wake up 3 hours later with WSAND imprinted on your forehead.